guys, Scott here from Scott's Bass Lessons again, and this week I'm going to be talking about using the plectrum, or the pick. A lot of my students ask me all the time whether it's a good or bad thing to use a plectrum. There's this common myth that you are cheating if you are using a plectrum, and so let me just get rid of that. You're not cheating if you use a plectrum, it just gives you a different sound. And in all honesty, if I was starting off again, you know, I'd make sure that I use the plectrum right from the start, as well as my fingers. Okay, don't limit yourself to just playing with your fingers or just playing with the pick. Why not play with both? Okay, so if you are playing with a pick, there's a couple of things you need to take into consideration as far as technique is concerned. If you look at a lot of players, when they're playing things of a certain tempo, they'll be just doing downstrokes normally. A downstroke is down like this, so you get, that kind of thing, okay? But after a certain tempo, you're gonna have to, you know, do something about the downstroke, and the key to get around this is playing down and up, okay? So you get a downstroke and an upstroke, okay? So down, up, down, up, down, up. And this is called alternate picking, okay? So see how my right hand is just down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Okay? You can do this with scales, a C major scale. Down, up, 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 down. Okay, instead of down, 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 all the just playing down like this, you want to play down, up, down, up, down. By doing this, you can get a lot faster. You try playing something, for instance, just with downs. Okay? Alternate picking. Okay, so how do you practice alternate picking? Well, a good thing is just to sort of like sit on one note. So what I've done here, I've created a grum groove for you to do this with. If you're watching this on YouTube, go to my website. The drum groove will be there just below the video. So click on that and just sit on one note, just doing alternate picking, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Okay, so this is the drum groove. I can't speak today. Okay, so just one note. Let's play a D. Doing there is playing down, up, down, up, down, up, down, okay, but with a groove. Now, another thing to take into consideration is string dampening. I'm getting that funky sound because I'm using this part of my palm just to dampen. That's it off there, so as I lay on the string, slightly, not too much. If it was too much, it would be, if I move it back, there we go. Too much. Back, move it back. So I would say it's on, laying on the strings, maybe sort of 10 mil, about a centimetre. Let's just listen to that groove again. So listen to the groove first, get used to the feel of it, because you really want to be locking in with that groove. Now, one, two, three, four. Thank you. drums really locking in. Now if you want to do that, all I'm doing is four chromatic notes to the D, then to the A, then to the D again, then to the A. So I'm looking at it as almost like a D7 or D major chord. To the D, to the A, to the D, to the A, to the D. If you're having problems locking in with the drums and you find yourself drifting away, which many people do, they concentrate so much on what they're playing that they actually drift away from the drum groove. If you're having that problem, there's a little tip I want to give you. Basically, I want you to simplify it and then start adding in the 16ths, okay? So start off just with quarter notes, 1, 2, 3, 4, along with the groove, okay? So here's the groove. So we're just going to play quarter notes. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this lets us kind of get comfortable with the groove. Now just on beat one, I want you to play the 16ths, okay? So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. Da 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 da. Now beat 1, 2. Doing there is we're playing 16ths on beats 1 and 2, and then 3 and 4 we're just playing quarter notes. So you get 1 E and a 2 E and a 3, 4, 1 E and a 2 E and a 3, 4, 1 E and a 2 E and a 3, 4. So do it on beat 1 first. So 1 E, 1 E and a 2, 3, 4, 1 E and a 2, 3, 4, da 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 da, 3, 4, da 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 da, 3, oh no, da 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 da, 3. One E and a two, three, four. Then on the two, 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 4, 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 4. And what that's doing is, when we play the 16ths, when we go back to playing the quarter notes, it almost lets us reset. So we're resetting to the tempo of the drums, which is just, it's highlighting whether we're going out of time with drums, basically. So let's try that again. So I'll do the 16ths on the beat 1 first, then I'll do 16ths on beat 2. There we go. So just quarters to start with, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. Now just on beat 1. Reset. Now beats 1, 2, and 3. We're leaving beat 4 with a long note. now, full bar. Two bars. See what I'm doing there? I'm just breaking it up between quarter notes and sixteenth notes just so I can reaffirm that I'm locking in with the drums, because it's so easy to not concentrate on the drums and kind of drift off onto your own sort of, you know, little path. And before, when I was playing the you can use it exactly the same with that. So you can just play it as quarter notes. Or eighth notes it'll be. It's nice to be able to swap between the two. Let's try that along with the track. Just gives you a little break to actually, you know, get in there with the drums. Hopefully you've enjoyed this lesson. I'm going to do some more lessons on the pick soon, so watch out for them. And remember, if you want to play along with the backing track, that's available on this page, on my website. So click the link below, it'll take you to the page, and then underneath the video there will be the backing track. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, subscribe to my website, subscribe to everything, and hopefully I'll see you soon. Take it easy and get in the shed.